For the past few weeks, court leader Raila Odinga has been demanding clarity on 140 billion shillings acquired from Eurobond, claiming the funds were misappropriated. A matter the ruling alliance through Deputy President William Ruto has dismissed, instead accusing Raila of attempting to chase away investors.
Kama wako na ukweli wowote, kama nia yao sio kuhujumu uchumi wa taifa letu la Kenya kwa kuendesha porojo ili wahisani waegezaji wasiweke rasilimali yao katika taifa letu.
But today the anti-graft body summoned Raila Odinga to provide information on Eurobond money he insists was stolen. The commission has set a date with Raila on Thursday at Integrity Center. And as the commission awaits the appearance of the opposition leader, Jubilee MPs led by Moses Kuria want Raila charged with perjury if he fails to prove his claims on stolen money.
If the former Prime Minister, Raila Odinga, is found to have given false information, he is going to be charged with perjury. That simple. Because it is an old and established dictum of the law that he who alleges must prove. And we must raise the bar of people making allegations.
The Jubilee lawmakers view Raila's claims as a diversionary tactic from electoral malpractices facing his co-principal Moses Wetangula.
We know that the calls on this Eurobond thing are basically meant to divert attention from the issues that have been raised by BBC on an investigation that is going on over the BAT SIGA scandal in the UK, on calls that have been made for IBC to take action in accordance with the law.
The anti-corruption body has already grilled senior officials from the National Treasury on the Eurobond cash and is expected to forward its findings to the Director of Public Prosecutions by next week. Kevin Wachira, Channel One News.